Valley Maniacs, welcome back to the channel. I am Valley Flying. This is Mobile Gamer, and we got some hot new rumors for you in this video. Drew is back, and he's going to reveal his source for all of these rumors over the past few months. And we're also discussing this blog post that was released yesterday. We're discussing this Magic event. What do you think of that Magic event, brother?
Hey, man, an Elite Six? That looks okay. And then, they're going to sell us some sort of, to get all five of the medallions, you're going to have to buy one of them.
Yes.
But then you would also get the costume. So we have to see what that price is going to be for the 3 million. We'll see.
We'll get some predictions. We'll get all that. But before we do all that, let's go to Drew because he has some hot new rumors and he's going to reveal his source.
Valley Maniacs, I've got a surprise for you today. I'm not at the beach anymore. I'm actually at Scalplay headquarters because I am revealing my source for all these hot new rumors over the past couple months. Yes. It is none other than your favorite community manager. It's community manager Whip with some hot new rumors of some characters coming in March. As you can see, he is very busy with all of his job that he's doing, all of his Learjet purchases, over all the hot Thanos giving orbs. But he has some hot rumors of a team coming up. Thank you, brother. He has a hot rumors of the team coming up in March, coming to Marvel Strike Force. And would you like to reveal for the Valley Club who are the hot characters coming and are getting reworked in March?
Are you ready for it? Are you ready for
the big news? I am ready!
All right, so here's the big news. The big news is that we have the West Coast Avengers.
The West Coast Avengers, Valley Maniacs!
The West is the best.
Oh, I love it! The West Coast is the best coast!
So that means there'll be three new characters and two reworks.
Two reworks! Who are the lucky characters getting reworked in March?
Hawkeye and War Machine.
Oh! They have TV series on Disney Plus!
Yeah. And then
it makes sense!
And then they'll be paired up with the following three characters. We've got Mockingbird.
Oh, Mockingbird!
Mockingbird,
Tigra!
And Wonder Man, right?
Wonder Man coming!
You're familiar with them, right?
They are part of the West Coast Avengers. I'm not, but I know you are, Valley Maniacs, so how excited are you? What is your hype level for the West Coast Avengers potentially coming?
You need to work on your presentation a little bit here. You need to say more things like rest assured and you asked for this.
Oh, I've not been to Scopely headquarters in the corporate
speak.
I've got to get trained in this visit at a Scopely headquarters. I'm hanging at the beach all. I don't know all the Scopely, the promises made.
You need to also understand the triangle of truth. You know the triangle of truth for here at Scopely. You familiar?
No, I'm not.
Okay.
I've heard rumors. I'm not actually a Scopely employee, despite what you might think.
All right, we need to practice. We here at Scopely at the top, believe in frustration marketing.
Frustration marketing, that seems like it's very, very much into what
frustration marketing, and that brings you to the corner right here. And we employ frustration marketing by deploying artificial scarcity.
Artificial scarcity?
Yes.
I've experienced a lot of that.
Yes. And then once you've experienced frustration marketing and artificial scarcity, we're going to sell you a surprise mechanics solution.
Oh my goodness!
Yes.
No wonder I'm always buying these solutions!
It's a part of the triangle of truth.
The masterminds are scalping!
The not Illuminati triangle of truth. It's not a scam and it's not gambling.
This is not a scam.
Most importantly, it is not gambling.
Not gambling,
if someone
not
told
a scam.
You it's gambling, that's wrong.
All right. Well, I am glad I'm taking this visit. There's much in the ways that I have to learn, in the ways of the force here at Scalpley.
Are you familiar with Decimal Point Jeff and Dial-Up Danny?
I have experienced many, many awesome things in my account from Decimal Point Jeff.
Dial-Up Danny was here the other day, and I felt like he didn't know what was up. Maybe you could replace him.
We will have a talk. Okay. And then, you know who I like? I like Compensation Carl.
Compensation Carl?
I've gotten a lot of good things from him.
Okay.
So So yes, let's go meet all of them. All right. The awesome cast of characters here at Scalpley.
Let's go to the weed lounge right
let's
over
go.
Here.
Let's go. It is raining.
Oh, the awesome rumors from Drew. What do you think of that? Do you know, were you aware of the West Coast Avengers before that?
I mean, Hawkeye's in a weird place right now, so I think that he'll be fine to be moved from Wave 1 Avengers. Wave 1 Avengers is pretty flexible, but this will break apart Power Armor for sure, which needs some love. You know what I mean? They really do.
They do. So what do you think is going to happen? Like, Power Armor was kind of a war offense team. Do you think if the West Coast Avengers comes to the game, they're going to be war offense replacing them?
I mean, a lot of people want to put them on the bench anyways. Power Armor is pretty much on the bench. So, you know, maybe they'll have to be revitalized with, you know, maybe like Hulkbuster or something.
Oh, hey. And that could so potentially become Iron Man. You've been wanting that for a while, right?
A proper Iron Man rework and Hulkbuster coming to the game. Who knows, right?
And are you familiar with these other characters? Tigra, Wonder Man, and I've known them. I've seen the West Coast Avengers comics all through when I was a kid growing up. So I'm familiar with their look. I've seen them on many covers of the West Coast Avengers. But yeah, it'll be cool if they come to the game.
Okay.
All right, but let's have this Magic event. Magic's getting an event coming up. We had a data mine on this just a little while ago. And the data mine is pretty accurate. Now they did have the information about Star-Lord, T'Challa Kid. We both made videos on that pretty extensively. But let's go down to this event here. Season Sorcery. Okay. Decorate your roster for the holidays on December 16th. So that's going to be a Thursday event. And we've had events like this in the past. What would you compare this event most to?
Shang-Chi. Shang-Chi's event looks like the most similar. That had 10 medallions. This has 5, whatever it is. They're called 5.
Ornaments.
Ornaments. Ornaments. Ornaments for Christmas. Okay, that makes sense. It does make sense.
All right, and we're gonna and these ornaments, we got the snowflake currency. We're getting them through milestones. We're getting them through unlocking them for various means, but one of them we're gonna have to purchase.
Correct. It looks like 3 of them you'll be able to do through the season sorcery milestone, which is gonna use the snowflake currency. It's gonna be very similar to that. If you go up a little bit, it shows how to get the, you can spend campaign energy, isolated energy, blitz, and then you just do your daily objectives. And the way that this typically works, and we'll have to find out, is how many full roster rotations will you have to do today to max out the rewards. And we usually don't know that until the day of. It's always a funny thing.
Typically it's about four rotations per day. And then I guess usually the 50 energies for the both the normal and the campaign, and or the ISO 8 and the campaign. And then these you're just getting a few different tokens for that in the daily objectives. So,
right.
So you're not getting per battle.
Usually the way this works is that the ultimate variable is how much extra blitzing you have to do. So the raid arena real time, it doesn't really count. It just counts in the daily objectives. And then how much money you're willing to spend, you know, using ISO 8 and then the campaign. You know, then it's just a function of blitzing at that point.
Yeah, so the important thing on this is don't claim all your milestones on this 16th until this event goes live. So be careful of that. In the morning, you're gonna give some objectives. Maybe you're doing arena battles, things like that. Don't claim any of these. Wait till this snowflake currency is in there on the 16th before that. Let's talk about some of these orbs. You gotta collect all 5 of them for that awesome Spider-Man No Way Home outfit, the black and gold one. What did you think of that outfit?
I don't care about outfits, but I do like that one.
Okay. Potentially going to spend on this one ornament that you have to buy to get that outfit?
Yeah, 3 of them are going to come from playing in the event. One of them is going to come from a milestone. And then the very last one is going to be something you're going to have to purchase. So right here, you got the first ornament right there, which is guarantees 50 magic shards. It's going to be great.
That's a good one.
So this is just by playing in the event. Blue ornament, you get a ton of ions. Boy, I need a lot of T2 ions. Blue ions, right?
I need, yeah. The T1's not as bad, but the T2 blues are really scarce. I'm opening a lot of those orbs, those blaster or brawler orbs, just for the ions. I'm not even needing some of the ISO 8s.
And then this seems super generous. In Elite 6.
This is.
Elite 6 seems super generous right there, so I'm excited about this for sure. And this is just by playing the event, which is just going to be a function of how much extra blitzing do I want to do.
Now I asked you yesterday on your video. I'm going to ask you again in case your answers change. Who are you thinking of using this Elite 6 on right now?
Oh,
one of the Web Warriors?
Yeah, it's going to be a Web Warrior. I'm not sure which one, but probably whatever Web Warrior is around at the time of that comes out. So it could be Ghost Spider, it could be Scarlet Spider, it could be Spider-Punk. We don't know the release date or times on that, but we'll have to see.
I'm going to guess probably Scarlet Spider. I think Spider-Gwen is going to come earlier, but both of them really good characters.
The movie's
to use
just
in
around the
opinion.
Corner, right? Like, not too far away.
Yeah, I think there's a data mine that she would be a blitz release, but we'll have to see on that. The pink ornament. Now, this isn't the 14th day of the calendar, and if we calculate that, that's going to be towards the end of the month. I think the 30th of December, if we look at that. So that's going to be right before the 1st of January. You're getting a bunch of purple, orange, and teal unique pieces.
Right.
And then this is the one that you have to buy.
This is controversial, right?
Yes. Well, we don't know what this low price is. You're going to get 3 million gold, which is good. I know a lot of players have this gold crunch that they have, but it says a special low price offer. We were discussing this yesterday.
Yeah.
What that low price would be. Now, I don't know if your answer shifted just yesterday. What would that low price for you be right now?
Here's the thing is, like, this is going to be the last Monopoly piece in the McDonald's game to get the Spider-Man costume. If you've played the Monopoly game at McDonald's, you know what I'm talking about. There's always that one piece that's missing.
Yeah.
So the white ornament is basically going to do two things. It'll get you 3 million gold, and it'll get you the No Way Home costume. So I don't see them selling this less than 20 bucks.
I want it to be 5. I might up my limit to 10 since yesterday, I want it to be as low as possible. It's a costume that gives you no gameplay advantage.
Right.
And it's gold, which I know a lot of players have bottlenecks. I don't have a really good, a really big gold bottleneck. So this for me, this is 10 bucks. Is it 20 for you?
I'd be happier if it was $15, but we'll have to see.
The rest of the blog post, there wasn't too much in it, but we did get this big thing. Phoenix is going to be a 5-star unlock. And yeah, it's getting an update. The repeating legendary event. And getting the 5-star unlock. We've had data mines about this a while ago that were refuted by Cerebra, but now it looks like it's actually happening. Right. What are your thoughts on this?
Well, I think this is good that Phoenix will now be 5 stars. Kind of keeps it the same as all the other legendary unlocks. And also, Magic doesn't really have a purpose unless she works with an entire team. She makes the team work together. But like, if you don't have Phoenix, there's no point in getting Magic. So I think this is, if they want to sell more Magic, they're going to have to.
They have to, yeah. And this is good. This is really good for newer players. Give them a war offense option for them. All right, and that is it. What was your most exciting part of this? The West Coast Avengers potentially coming to the game, the Magic event, or that newer players get it?
The Elite Six in the event.
All right. Yeah, I didn't even get the Phoenix part, but yeah, the Elite Six is the most exciting. I always like the rumors in the West Coast. I'm finally glad that we got to see Drew's source. People are asking, who is Drew getting these rumors from all this time?
Who would have known?
I never would have put that together.
It kind of makes sense.
Well, thank you for joining me. The links to Mobile Gamer channel will be down below. I love the shirt. Fist bump. Can we do a real fist bump? Oh, there.
We can do a real one?
Can we do a double? Double. Yeah. Valley by Mobile Gamer out. Have a great rest of your day, guys.